Welcome to the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show, a real estate investment program. Listen and learn how to use real estate to build wealth and passive income streams for you and your family. We bring you experts every day to discuss and answer your questions on everything from single-family homes all the way up to 600-plus unit apartment complexes. And now, the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show.
You're listening to the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show. This is Lori Bass, and as always, we're working on your financial freedom. I've got a super great show for you today that I am so excited about because I'm going to introduce you to a multimillionaire who is really one of the most down-to-earth people, kind of that millionaire next door type person. He is somebody who has thrived in our program, and he has been kind enough to come on the show today to share his story. I'm going to give you a little bit of his background. He has been a member of Lifestyles Unlimited now for only 5 years, not that long. He joined back in 2014, and John is a highly educated man who got his degree in engineering from Texas A&M, and whoop, I mean, sorry, got to say that, folks, because my son is an Aggie, so got to give it the old 1-2-3 there, but he found himself, basically, he told us, with more money than he had time. You know, he was caught up in the rat race of work, as you know, we all are familiar with. I spoke a lot about that yesterday on our show and how, you know, our crazy schedules keep us crazy and really sometimes can get the best of us. And, you know, he was trying to figure a way of what to do with all the excess money he had from his amazing career in engineering. Since joining our program, okay, John has purchased 29 apartment complexes through syndications, and we're going to talk about that over the last 5 years. And only after 2.5 years of joining our program did John retire from his six-figure W-2 income. Wow, I mean, that's a big deal. Welcome to the show, John. What an accomplishment. We're so happy to have you.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm honored.
Yeah, so why don't you start off by telling us your story? Let's tell the listeners, give us your story on how you got started.
Actually, I started investing in 2010 via my younger brother, who was a new member of Lifestyles in the Houston office. He was very successfully buying some single-family properties and duplexes. And when I saw how well the numbers worked, I asked him if I could be a passive investor with him, and he graciously allowed me to do that. So that introduced me to real estate investing. He was a new member of Lifestyles, and that is where he learned how to do this. So after that, I decided, you know, look, 2011, foreclosure crisis, there are what I perceive to be bargains everywhere up in DFW area, all sorts of foreclosures going for, you know, half to two-thirds of what they were selling for just a year or 2 years before. So I started investing in single-family properties and DFW, too. You know, there was a part of me that thought, you know, anything my little brother can do, certainly I can do as well.
Yeah.
And I wanted to get some more money in it.
Okay. So you started, this was prior then, before joining Lifestyles Unlimited, you dove in to the single-family investments then?
I did. I was fortunate enough to finally find a real estate agent who was used to working with investors, mm-hmm. and I learned an incredible amount from her. She knew what was what to do or not do in rehabs, and mm-hmm. back then in 2011, there were foreclosures everywhere, and you could pick and choose. So I bought six of them at that time. Every one of them was just a carpet and paint type thing, no big deal on rehab. And she found my renters for me. Fortunately, she taught me also to screen tenants carefully, do the credit check and so forth. And so it turned out to be a very easy business to run. And I did mm-hmm. make one huge mistake with all that, Lori. I was and still am, very fiscally conservative person. So I bought these six properties up here for all cash. Tremendous mm-hmm. amount of equity tied up in these properties. But, of course, they cash flowed like crazy. And I did not actually need extra income at that time, but those houses ended up putting our three kids through college without having to dip into our savings. So I looked at that as a major home run.
Absolutely. You know, and I have done several shows on touched on several of the things that you just talked about. One of them was, you know, dealing with certain realtors. You do have to find one. Of course, when you join our program, that's one of the awesome things is we have our own realtors that know how to find these types of investment properties that we're looking for. The work is already done for us, and that's such a beautiful thing, you know. But you talking about, you know, purchasing these single-family properties all cash in. There's so many people out there that think, you know, that's the way to go. And, you know, what we are taught in Lifestyles Unlimited is, you know, a whole different way to do that. So why don't you bring our listeners then to now you've purchased those homes, you've got them up and running, but talk to us then about once you joined Lifestyles Unlimited and how you took off from there.
You know, I actually joined originally to learn how to do single-family better.
Mm-hmm.
And certainly I did, and I'll tell you exactly how much better. I bought one more house with a mortgage exactly by the Lifestyles map right after I joined, and my initial cash-on-cash rate of return on that house was 22%. The houses I bought for all cash, I targeted a 7 to 8% rate of return. So three times better rate of return when done by following the Lifestyles map. That's a major difference.
Absolutely, absolutely. And all of that, a lot of that has to do with varying degrees, depreciation, different types of things that, you know, get a little bit more detailed. Those are the things you learn when you join Lifestyles and you come to some of our free seminars. But tell us about now, when you joined Lifestyles, tell us about you decided to do the passive investing. You know, we have people out there with varying degrees of experience, you know, with regard to real estate. Some of them think about, you know, investing in real estate as what we're talking about right now, you know, single family properties. And then there's some people out there who have a little bit more money in their pocket. They might be a little bit more savvy with regard to investing, and they're looking towards the multifamily, which means apartment complex, that type of investing. You know, not everybody understands all the different ways you can invest. In our program, if you want to get involved in, you know, apartment complexes and multifamily, there's several ways of investing, and one of them is to become a passive. So explain to our listeners exactly, you know, when you joined, your aha moment in that first two-day seminar and how that worked out for, you know, the passive way of investing.
So the biggest aha moment for my first 2 days was the simple fact that regular people like me could invest in multifamily properties. You know, they're structured as what's called a syndication. There will be what we call a lead investor that actually gets the deal put together and then typically will raise capital from what we call passive investors. This all has to be done according to Securities and Exchange rules and regulations, and Lifestyles teaches us all about that. So the 100,000-foot view for me was practicing engineer. I had more money than I had time, so it was obvious to me that passive investing was a route for me because I could simply invest my money with people that were highly trained in how to do this effectively, and I could enjoy the fruits of their labor. So that became a focus for me. It's all about two things if you're going to be a passive investor in multifamily. First, education. Our education happens automatically if we show up to as many events as we can, whether in person or online. There are many online events. And then also, Lifestyles has developed a university-level online training course where you will watch videos about specific topics and then demonstrate your proficiency in that particular topic by getting 100% rating on the following quiz. So education is, you will get into this, you will get out of this group what you put into it. Lifestyles makes it very easy for us to become educated. The second big component is networking. Networking within a group of successful, like-minded people. We have to get to know these lead investors that put these deals together. And they have to get to know us as well. We're going to invest with people we know, like, and trust, and they want people they know, like, and trust in their deals also. Education and networking are the two big fundamentals in multifamily investing.
Right, right. And I think, you know, I can remember when my husband and I joined and attended our first meeting too, you know, we came there really with in mind exactly the way you did, thinking about, you know, single family investment. And well, that is a great way to get started. Definitely, you know, most people in the program and most of our very experienced people in the program definitely started with single family investing, you know, as you did prior to coming to the program. But I think what's really really neat is that there are lots of people out there who are very educated as yourself, who are busy, busy people. You know, we have doctors, lawyers, lots of engineers in our program. And, you know, they find themselves knee deep in their career. They're not ready to leave their career. They're not ready to retire. You know, some people enjoy what they do. It doesn't just because you can doesn't mean they want to, but they found ways to come and bring their money and invest it outside the stock market, which doesn't pay a passive income, correct? I mean, you were able to retire in 2.5 years because of the passive income, right?
Exactly. It had nothing to do with stock market. I was pulling money out of the stock market.
Well, we're going to talk more about that because that is really the key when we return. You're listening to the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show, and this is Lori Bass. Questions, you can email me at asklori@luinc.com. That's ask, L-O-R-I-E, at luinc.com. In a moment, we'll return to further our discussion with John when the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show continues. Welcome back to the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show. This is Lori Bass. Today, we've been visiting with one of Lifestyles Unlimited's most successful passive investors. And before the break, we were talking about his success story, and he was filling us in on passive investing. Welcome back to the show, John.
Thank you.
So, you know, John, yesterday on my show, I was talking about, you know, the nine, basically the title of my show was The 9 Reasons to Leave Corporate America Behind and Work for Yourself and Become a Real Estate Investor. And, you know, I had fun with that show because how many of us out there really do want to leave America, I mean, corporate America behind, you know? And you are the perfect, you're the poster child, if you will, in my opinion, for this. For our program, you know, so you just fit right in today with the show. And yesterday I spoke about, you know, trading time for money and how investing in real estate actually buys back our time while receiving a passive income. So we were just getting ready to talk about that. And tell our listeners, John, how the passive income you've earned on your investment, how that's changed you and your family's life.
Well, it has completely changed our lives. You know, I did retire, replace my after-tax income 2.5 years after I joined the program by diligently following the math. And some ways seem small. For example, I used to get up at 5:00 every morning to get ready to go to work. Now my German Shepherd wakes me up in the morning when she's ready to go out. You know,
right.
It sounds like a small thing, but it's huge to me. My time is my own. We are actually building a second home down at Galveston in one of the canal communities right now. That certainly would not have happened without Lifestyles Unlimited. I walk our two dogs. My wife has a Great Dane, and I have a German Shepherd. I walk them every morning, and they just thoroughly enjoy it, and so do I. I used to listen to Dale's podcast during the commute to work every day, 45 minutes to an hour each way. Now, while I'm walking our dogs, I listen to the podcast and stay up with it that way. The other day at the office, somebody tossed me a Lifestyles stress ball. It had a Lifestyles logo on it. Mm-hmm. I squeezed it a couple times, and I tossed it back to him and said, you know, I really don't need this. I don't have stress in my life anymore.
Right, right. Yep. Because, you know, the days of of traveling to and from. That's exactly what my show was about yesterday, talking about following the brake lights to the office and following the brake lights home. And, you know, what a rat race that was. And so isn't it ironic that here you're on the radio now telling your success story, but over 5 years ago, you were caught up in that rat race and just listening to the program, right? How ironic is that?
It is. I continue to marvel at my good fortune that my younger brother Carl introduced me to Lifestyles when he did. I just wish I had joined earlier when I was first investing with him. Think where I'd be now.
Well, you know, and it's funny you say that. That kind of brings me to the next subject that I was going to talk about with you. You know, how do you feel the change in real estate cycles affects those who want to invest today? You know, like, for instance, 10 years ago, I've heard people say, you know, that was the golden ages of real estate investing. But today we're in a seller's market, and we definitely are in a seller's market. How do you feel and what do you think these changes, how do you think they affect us when we're investing?
Well, the leads and passive investors certainly have to be very selective in what we invest in. But that was the case back then, too. I was talking with someone the other day about 5 years ago when I joined. I told them everybody was saying, God, I can't believe how high these prices are now. You know, when is this going to end? Are we toward the end of the cycle? Well, now here we are 5 years later. My net worth has doubled again in the 5 years that I've been a Lifestyles member. And everybody's saying the same thing. You know, these prices are so high, I can't believe it. The way to look at it is not how many dollars per door or how high prices are. The way to look at it is we do this for cash flow. Can you do this deal, make some improvements in the property, get the rents up to market, and have higher cash flow, or perhaps at some point do even a cash-out refinance, get most or all of your investment back? Those deals are happening now, today. Mm-hmm. Last year, I had 4 sales with very, very large capital gains, and I reinvested all that money into 9 more multifamily deals last year. It's easy to find good deals to invest in. You just have to make sure they fit your preferred box, your style.
Right, right. You know, I want to pick this back up when we come from our break. We've got to move to our next break. This is Lori Bass. The Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show continues in a moment, when we can hear more of John's tips and advice for successful investing. You're listening to the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show. This is Lori Bass. So happy to be with you today, and we appreciate you taking your time out on this morning to listen to us. We've been talking today to a very successful member of our program. John has invested in 29 multifamily properties and retired himself in only 2.5 years after joining our program. And he's been sharing his success story with us. And that's been really kind of fun and exciting to listen to. And right before the break, John, we were talking about the market and how the market changes. And, you know, how you'll hear a lot of skeptics say, it's over with. We're at the top of our market and there's no more deals to be had. And I wanted to go back and talk a little bit more about that. And, you know, I love how you talked about, you know, when you joined, the prices were already starting to go up. But we don't have a magic ball, right? None of us have a magic ball. Can you speak a little bit more to that with regard to if there's a good and bad time to invest?
You know, as Lifestyles teaches us, Lori, we can make money in any type of market. The trick is to find those gems, those diamonds in the rough, and be selective about what we buy. I bought into 9 more deals last year using sales proceeds from sales last year with big capital gains. There are deals out there. We just have to network and have ourselves educated enough to recognize those opportunities when it comes along. Here's my philosophy. I am essentially fully invested at all times. I do have my sleep well at night money that is not in real estate. The trick is always be like a farmer. Never eat your seed corn. Always reinvest, cash out refinances, always reinvest sales proceeds. That way, your net worth and your income continue to grow even in retirement. That's the whole trick.
Yep. Let's talk about that for a minute. You know, we have a lot of members who have decided to, you know, take out their 401k. We definitely have people in the program to help us do that in a smart way by avoiding the penalty. There's ways to get around it. And then people who are taking their money out of their IRAs and deciding they're done with investing in the stock market. And they earn back, you know, the taxes that they pay on that once they take it out, you know, their returns double that in a lot of the investments that they make. Did you decide to do that? And tell us about that. Have you ever taken any money out of any of your 401ks? And tell us how that worked for you.
I absolutely have. I first used a bunch of after-tax money in regular stock market accounts. But then when that money started really dwindling, you know, I had a choice. Either take it out of the 401k and IRA stuff, or don't invest anymore and don't be able to retire. So for me, it was a clear choice. The numbers are absolutely compelling, even when you pay the taxes and the penalty. So it is like a rusty dagger in the heart every time I did that. But when I'd see a really nice deal with someone I knew I wanted to invest with, I didn't hesitate. I shoved that rusty dagger into my heart, pulled out the money, and did the investment. And it has tremendously worked out well. It's worth doing the taxes and the penalty, no question about it.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about some of the profitability in some of your deals, you know, the returns that you've made. Let's tell our listeners so that they can kind of get a feel for, you know, because I think you're right. You know, that I think you put it perfectly, a dagger in the heart, you know, and it is a dagger in the heart to think about, you know, that's, we're taught don't ever do that. You know, we're taught the traditional set mindset, which is save your way to retirement. But, you know, one of the things I talked about in my show yesterday is that more and more Americans are finding themselves having to work 10 extra years to retire because that model absolutely did not work. So, you know, let's talk about, you know, the profitability a bit with our listeners and, you know, talk to them about, you know, that dagger may feel hurt. It may cut to the core, but there's money to be made.
Absolutely, there is. One of my favorite multifamily investments is a smaller community. It's down in San Antonio. And it was a deeper value play to start with. First-time lead, but she had a project management background. She is a very driven woman. And so I stepped up. Yes, I will sign on the loan with you as well as be an investor. About a week before we were set to close on that property, a giant hailstorm hit that area of San Antonio.
Oh, yeah.
And this property... Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
I do.
Softball-sized hail.
It was a big deal.
A huge deal. So, you know, what do we do now? Well, with the guidance of lifestyle.
You know, I'm going to interrupt you real quick, and we're going to, John, okay. I'm going to interrupt you because we got to move to a break, but we're going to pick this up when we return. This is Lori Bass. We'll continue our discussion about passive investing and learn how you can get started on the road when Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show continues. We're back with the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show, and this is Lori Bass. Before the break, we were visiting with one of Lifestyle's very educated and experienced passive investors. He's been giving our listeners great tips on how to get started on their road to financial freedom. And if you're just tuning in, I want to give you a few tidbits of his background. John was a very successful engineer with a degree from Texas A&M, and he found himself with more money than time, and he wanted to invest it, and he joined our program, and he's only been a member for 5 years, five short years, and the crazy part about it is he retired himself in only 2.5 years. And before the break, John, welcome back, John. Before the break, we were talking about some of your investments, and we were kind of talking a bit about when is there a good and bad time to invest. Your information was so awesome on that. And you were starting to fill our listeners in a bit on how you actually have taken money out of your 401k to invest in real estate and talk about the profitability in some of your deals. Let's talk about some of that, and let's give our listeners an idea of why it's worth taking money out of your 401k or IRA and invest in real estate.
Well, just continuing with the story of the community I was talking about, less than 2 years after that investment in that horrible beat-up property, we did a cash-out refinance, got 100% of our money back out of it, no taxes due on a cash-out refinance. That's just money in your pocket to reinvest in another one. And that property, every quarter, is paying mid-double-digit returns to us based on our original investment that we already have back.
Gosh,
so if you look at it on one face, yeah. that's an infinite rate of return now on that original investment.
Exactly. I mean, so think about that for you listeners. Let's say you put $25,000 in this deal. Walk them through that. Let's just talk for a round number, $25,000. They put $25,000 in. They got it back out. Give them that scenario of how that worked on that.
Yeah, we got our entire original investment back out of that property, and it is now paying on an annualized basis about 15% rate of return back to all of us. We don't have any money invested in it, but it's paying 15% to all of us of our original investment back four times a year. You know, every quarter we get one-fourth of that. So what did I do with my cash-out refinance money? Non-taxable event. It's all back in my checking account. Go reinvest it in another property. Mm-hmm. That way your net worth and your income continue to grow through time.
Exactly. And, you know, I challenge, right? Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah. One comment, too. You know, yes, you have a big tax obligation when you pull that money out of an IRA or 401k. However, the recent changes in the tax law in late 2017 give us tremendous first-year deductions that can offset some or sometimes even all of that tax liability from pulling that money out in the first place. So it's not like you're going to have to pay 20% plus the penalty on that money necessarily. You're going to get some really good first year and subsequent year tax deductions to help offset that.
And I can't say that this is the truth. I haven't met one member who has done this, who has taken their money out and invested it. I haven't met one member, have you, John, that's regretted it? Not one.
No, everybody gets all excited about doing it.
Yeah. You know, and talking about that rate of return that you were receiving now, once you were able, they refinanced, you were able to pull out the money that you had invested. Now what you're receiving is that passive income. And so you're earning 15%, correct, on that money. I challenge anybody out there to go to the stock market right now and find an account that's going to pay them 15% return. They're hard to find, right? And you're at risk. And it's not even paying you a passive income, right? I could go on and on, right?
Exactly right. That every property you buy buys back part of your time from corporate America. And just keep reinvesting, and you can retire as well. It takes longer if you have a high income and not much savings. It takes a shorter period of time if you have good savings and not a big income. But in retirement, your net worth and income can continue to grow if you follow the math.
And you know, I've noticed you've said that following the map, and that's something that, you know, we're definitely going to talk about here in our next segment. We're getting ready to go to another break. This is Lori Bass. John, I know you probably get asked this question often, and so do I, and that's how we got started in this business. Well, it all starts with our free workshops that I have been talking about today. And actually, John teaches some of these free workshops in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. And they're offered all across the U.S. If you want to learn more about attending one, give us a call at 866-945-6565. That's 866-945-6565. Or visit our website, lifestylesunlimited.com, and click free. There you can see a listing of where they're offered all across the U.S. Please join us for our last segment in a moment, where we'll wrap up our discussion with John, and we'll discuss more about the free seminars he teaches, all when the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Show continues.
Did you know that every dollar you invest in real estate makes you money five ways? Cash flow, money in your pocket each month. Equity capture, the thousands of dollars you create when you have the right team and buy the right property using the right map. Appreciation, real estate can increase in value over time. Equity buildup, renters pay down your mortgage each month. And finally, the tax advantage. When done correctly, real estate investors pay no taxes on our cash flow and capital gains. At Lifestyles Unlimited, these are the five ways we make money in real estate, which is why real estate accounts for more millionaires in the world today than any other investment vehicle. You should have some real estate in your portfolio. To learn how to attend a Lifestyles Unlimited free workshop, call 866-971-8970 or go to lifestylesunlimitedpodcast.com and register for the next available workshop. That's 866-971-8970 or go to lifestylesunlimitedpodcast.com.
We're back with the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show, and this is Lori Bass. Today, we've had the opportunity to hear from a very successful, a very educated, all-around great guy, an Aggie, I might add. Whoop, and I have to say that one last time for all you Aggies out there. But John is one of Lifestyles Investors who retired himself in 2.5 years. And, you know, you hear us sometimes in our program say, you know, that you can retire yourself in 5 years. We say that often. Well, it's no joke, folks. I mean, we mean it when we say it, and John has lived it. Welcome back to the show, John.
Thank you.
So, John, I want to spend the last segment of our show talking a bit about the seminars. And I want to talk about, you know, when you went to your first 2-day seminar. So tell us about that, and tell us about, you know, the people you met at the meeting. You know, I know there's skeptics in the room. Were you one? Tell us a little bit about that.
I absolutely was a skeptic. Nobody's more fiscally conservative than me, even to this day. I actually happened to sit next to a young lady who asked a million questions in the 2-day seminar. And I thought to myself, you know, those are perceptive questions. This lady's going to be really successful in this group. Supriya ended up winning the National Apartment Association Award for Property of the Year this year. I sat
wow.
next to her in my first 2 days. Now, there was a wide cross-section of people. I have a good friend that's a mailman in the group. I have another good friend that is my consulting vet in the group. He's a retired veterinarian now.
Uh-huh.
There could be your next-door neighbor. Could be anybody in the group. Wide cross-section.
Yep.
And
yep.
we all can be successful by following the map.
Yep. And you've said that several times about following the map. And that's exactly what we're giving. We're given a map in our program to follow. You know, I hear other programs sometimes coining that phrase, you know, follow your financial freedom map. And are they really giving out a map? Because we are given a map, correct?
It absolutely is. Dell's been doing this for 29 years via Lifestyles Unlimited. We are not reinventing the wheel. We are following tried and true principles and methods that have been developed way before we ever even heard of Lifestyles. And we're simply standing on the shoulders of giants and following a very well-established path to success.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So when you first joined the program, what did your family say? I mean, what were their reactions and your friends, you know? Because, I mean, I know when my husband and I first joined, we probably didn't tell anybody for a while because of the reactions that we had. And now we scream it from the rooftops because we're so excited about it, you know? And I wish we had been that way from day one. And I hope our new members are that way from day one because, as you said, we're standing on tried and true principles. This is nothing new. There's no reinventing the wheel here. So what did you encounter with your family and friends?
My wife was very supportive of it. She's always been supportive of whatever financial decisions that I make, and we've been successful through our married life, you know, financially. I didn't talk about it much with friends until I started really having some really good success. Mm-hmm. But I've had several of my old work friends that have become members. Two of them, very recently, they're brand new members from a company I used to work for a few years ago. I had forgotten that we had talked about it back during our work time, but they remembered it, got in touch with me, got set up for the workshop, and now they are members as well. So they, too, will be very successful. Smart guys have capital to deploy, and they're going to get busy doing that. So it's really a fun thing to watch that happen.
Now, you yourself teach these workshops. Give our listeners a little bit about that. You're teaching these in the Dallas area, correct?
That's right. First part is about a mindset change, the difference between the middle class or employee mentality and the millionaire mentality. About two-thirds of the presentation is the nuts and bolts of how we make money in real estate. And I use examples from my own investing career. So they're real-life examples, very easy to teach. I love seeing the light bulb come on in people, and I know when they go to David Fisher or Dell's or Brian Sifford's two-day seminar, they are going to become successful as well, and that makes me feel good. Two of our kids are Preferred Investor Group members now. My wife and I are successful financially. We've got it made, so to speak. So I'm focused on legacy, my kids' legacy, and getting new members integrated into the group that will be also become very successful. I love that. It makes me feel good.
Yep, yep. And legacy is what it's all about, right? We can leave a legacy behind with our real estate, and the beauty of it is it's all tax-free to our kids, correct?
That's right.
Yep. Legacy
is
what it's
about.
Yep. Well, let me ask you a question. I want to thank you so much, John, for being on our show today. It's been such an honor to have you. Thank you for being here.
I appreciate it, Lori. I'm very passionate about this because of the awesome power of passive income from real estate.
Well, I want to say to our listeners, are you ready? Are you ready to get out there? Give us a call at 866-945-6565. We strongly suggest you don't get into the real estate world alone, so come to one of our free workshops and find a mentor. That's 866-945-6565. This is Lori Bass. Thank you for listening. I look forward to talking to you again soon. Remember, it's not the money, it's the lifestyle.
The Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show is for entertainment purposes only. Please consult a professional regarding your personal investment needs. Nothing presented on the Lifestyles Unlimited Real Estate Investor Radio Show constitutes an endorsement, recommendation, offer, or solicitation to buy or sell any product or security.